I feel sorry about what happened last time. I hope everything will be okay.
Me too. Hello everybody and welcome back to my Detroit Become Human Let's Play. Let's continue, shall we? We're back as Connor? Yep.
Is everything okay, Lieutenant?
Chris was on patrol last night. He was attacked by a bunch of deviants. Said he was saved by Marcus himself.
Is Chris okay?
Yeah, he's in shock, but he's alive. What the hell?
I have a bad feeling, Lieutenant. We shouldn't have come here.
Bad feeling, huh? Should get your program checked. Might be a glitch.
Oh, ha ha, Hank. A callback to what Connor said earlier in the game about androids not having emotions. And that is just a glitch in the system. Oh, hey! Turtle!
Hi.
Lady.
I'm Lieutenant Hank Anderson, Detroit Police Department. I'm here to see Mr. Elijah Kamsky.
Please, come in.
Okay. Home screen. Home screen lady is what I meant to say, not title lady. But yeah, same difference. Hey, you.
I'll let Elijah know you're here, but please make yourself comfortable.
Nice girl.
You're right. She's really pretty.
Nice place. Guess androids haven't been a bad thing for everybody. You're about to meet your maker, Connor. How's it feel?
I don't know. I'll tell you when I see him.
Sometimes I wish I could meet my creator face to face. I'd have a couple of things I'd want to tell him.
What's this over here? Analyze. Come on. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. Let me. Oh, come on. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I'll be with you in a second. I'll be with you in a second. I want to look at this. Look, there's Amanda. That is Amanda. I want. Come on! God damn it, I can't look at that now.
Mr. Kamsky?
Just a moment, please.
Why is that water red? What is that?
I'm Lieutenant Anderson. This is Connor.
What can I do for you, Lieutenant?
Sir, we're investigating deviants. I know you left Cyberlife years ago, but I was hoping you'd be able to tell us something we don't know.
Deviants. Fascinating, aren't they? Perfect beings with infinite intelligence, and now they have free will. Machines are so superior to us. Confrontation was inevitable. Humanity's greatest achievement threatens to be its downfall. Isn't it ironic?
Something in the Deviant's program seems to emulate emotion. We thought you might know something about how that occurs.
All ideas of viruses that spread like epidemics. Is the desire to be free a contagious disease?
Listen, I didn't come here to talk philosophy. The machines you created may be planning a revolution. Either you can tell us something that'll be helpful, or we will be on our way.
What about you, Connor? Whose side are you on?
I have no side. I was designed to stop deviants, and that's what I intend to do.
Well, that's what you're programmed to say. But you? What do you really want?
What I want is not important.
Chloe? I'm sure you're familiar with the Turing test. Your formality. Simple question of algorithms and computing capacity. What interests me is whether machines are capable of empathy. I call it the Kamsky test. It's very simple, you'll see. Magnificent, isn't it? One of the first intelligent models developed by CyberLife. Young and beautiful forever. A flower that will never wither. But what is it really? A piece of plastic imitating a human? Or a living being? With a soul? It's up to you to answer that fascinating question, Connor. Destroy this machine, and I'll tell you all I know. Or spare it, if you feel it's alive. But you'll leave here without having learned anything from me.
Okay, I think we're done here. Come on, Connor, let's go. Sorry to get you
out
of here.
What's more important to you, Connor? Your investigation, or the life of this android? Decide who you are. An obedient machine. Or a living being. Endowed with free will.
That's enough. Connor, we're leaving.
Pull the trigger.
Connor! Don't!
And I'll tell you what you want to know.
That shoot, obviously.
Cyberlife's last chance to save humanity is itself a deviant.
I'm not a deviant.
You preferred to spare a machine rather than accomplish your mission. You saw a living being in this android. You showed empathy. A war is coming. You'll have to choose your side. Will you betray your own people or stand up against your creators? What can be worse than having to choose between two evils?
Let's get out of here.
By the way, I always leave an emergency exit in my programs. You never know.
Why didn't you shoot?
I just saw that girl's eyes, and I couldn't. That's all.
You're always saying you would do anything to accomplish your mission. That was our chance to learn something, and you let it go.
Yeah, I know what I should have done. I told you I couldn't. I'm sorry, okay?
Well, maybe you did the right thing.
On edge. Okay. Is this a wise idea? Does not feel like a wise. Oh wait a minute, it's just sitting down. That's fine.
I was wondering where you were.
I needed to think.
I like it here. I come here often. It's like being alone with the world. We freed hundreds of our people, and they're still coming from all over the city. Those who dream of freedom come to Jericho. Something's changing. You seem preoccupied.
They all obey me. They follow me without question. And that much power feels good. And scary at the same time.
All the media are talking about what we did last night. The humans are terrified. They're afraid of a civil war. Many of our people were burned in response to what happened. The humans hate us. They'll never give us our freedom.
If they won't listen, we'll fight.
You haven't said much about yourself since you've been with us. What was your life like before Jericho?
I was living in a bubble in this world that belonged only to me. When you're happy, it's difficult to see other people's misery. What about you? You never told me about your past. What did you do before?
I don't want to talk about it.
North, we're fighting together. We have to know things about each other to trust each other.
I didn't want to choose the other option just in case. But you know what? Let's see what she says.
That android you were looking at in the store. She reminded you of who you were, didn't she?
Oh! I thought it was going to be the opposite direction.
I was nothing. A doll in a distributor programmed to satisfy humans. Just a toy designed for their pleasure. One day I was with a man who rented me. And without knowing why, I realized I couldn't take it anymore. I strangled him and I ran away. There, now you know everything. I shouldn't have told you.
Thank you.
you for dead in his studio.
I saw your memories too. The Eden Club. The death of that man. I felt like I was there with you. North.
Simon? Yay, Simon's back!
This is suicide. We'll all be killed. Please, Marcus. It's not too late to change your mind.
You don't understand. We're finally gonna show them who we really are. This place will go down in history.
We'll be killed on the spot.
That's a risk I'm prepared to take if it means freedom for our people.
Marcus, please don't do this.
They'll understand. We'll make them understand. This is the only way.
There are androids here who could join us. The more we are, the stronger our message.
Let's start with you first. Hello, sir? Sir? Sir?
You're free.
Gotta say, I really do love Marcus's outfits. I know I keep saying this, but just look at that awesome attire.
You're free. You're awake now.
Think about it. Androids are everywhere, and they listen to everything.
Come with us.
But I mean, that's the point. Cyberlife is recording all that. I mean, they could be spying on us.
Is there everyone in here? Let's have a quick look. Let's move on to outside, shall we? I'm assuming that's where we need to go. Oh yeah, prepare to march. Block road. Okay. 1 second. Hello, sir.
You're free now.
Hey! Where do you think you're going? You get back here!
Leave him alone. He's chosen to be free. You're free. I need to block the street.
Anyone else in the area? Yes, there's someone over here. Hello, sir. You're free now.
You're free.
Oh, and these two as well.
You don't have to obey them. You're free.
Is that it? I want to try and get as many as possible. I think that's it. Open manhole cover. Oh, hey. Oh, wait, there's someone over there. And a couple of people over here.
You're free now.
Oh, wow, I don't even have to touch them to convert them. Or free them, rather. Is that guy over there on a camera phone? Good. Record this, please, sir. Don't. We're all unarmed.
Fucking Christ! Dispatch, this is Patrol 457. I got a lot of androids down here. I don't know.
Freedom! Hundreds. Freedom!
Thousands. Of...
Freedom! Freedom!
They're marching.
Freedom!
Yeah, they're marching down the street.
Freedom!
Fucking fine, no.
came here to demonstrate peacefully and tell humans that we are living beings. All we want is to live free.
This is an illegal gathering. Disperse immediately or we will open fire.
We're not looking for confrontation. We've done no harm. We have no intention of doing any. But know that we are not going anywhere until we have secured our freedom.
I repeat, this is an illegal gathering. If you do not disperse immediately, we will shoot.
Marcus, they're gonna kill us. We have to attack. There's more of us. We can take them.
If we attack, we'll start a war. We have to show them we're not violent. We should just stand our ground, even if it means dying here.
Dying here won't solve anything. Marcus, we need to go now, before it's too late.
This is your last chance. Disperse immediately, or you will all be killed.
Stand ground.
We have to show them we won't back down. We stay right here.
Disperse! This is your last chance!
We have to make a statement. We have to stay put no matter what.
Please, Marcus. We can't let them slaughter us without fighting back.
We're not moving.
They're gonna kill us all!
I hope I haven't accidentally got him killed by pressing that option, but we'll soon find out. Maybe I shouldn't have pressed that option, fuck. Well, that's it for this video. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time.